To the Nancy Pelosi point, is this, Charles, something we're going to hear from Democrats, more of a racial tone to the charge that this is somehow coming after Eric Holder and President Obama because of their race?
It's hard to decide if this is just a pernicious charge that she knows isn't true, or if she's just being wacky. I mean, after all, a couple of days ago, she said she could have arrested Karl Rove and had him detained in the dungeon, the prison, under the House of Representatives. An interesting idea, which would have been interesting to actually watch. I'm not sure how seriously I take her. This is preposterous, and the reason is that if Holder had decided to turn over the documents, there wouldn't have been a contempt citation, and her whole theory would have collapsed. So it wasn't in the hands of the Republicans, it was in the hands of Holder, and he made his decision to not release the documents. But I'm rather touched by what Jay Carney had said about the need to hold the documents back because of a respect for the separation of powers. This comes 10 days after the administration has just rewritten unilaterally the immigration laws in a way that Obama himself has repeatedly said is a gross attack on the separation of powers itself. So you've got a lot of stuff happening here, as well as intimating that the Attorney General had stopped a program that, by his own words, he hadn't heard about. All of this is rather curious.